guys. I've got a little treat for you this evening. I've got a couple of items that I picked up off of Gumtree this evening, and I'm just about to unbox them and test them. And I thought you might like to see what I've got. Most importantly, let's get the interesting one out of the way. Here it is. Ta-da! Atari Jaguar. UK edition, official UK product. I don't know very much about these, but those of you who know much about me, which is probably not that many of you, I'm a big games collector. I will just show you in a second. Excuse the camera. Here's a few of my items here. Got a nice little display, Sega and Nintendo. Selection of consoles there. And games, bits and bobs. But for the moment, we're focusing on this bad boy here. So I'm just going to pop the camera back on the tripod. Yeah, so when I saw this appear locally on Gumtree, I couldn't ignore it. It was a little bit pricey, but you really don't see these very often at all. So I had to pick it up. It was being sold as untested for spares. So I don't even know if it worked, but the exciting thing is it had quite a lot of games with it, so I had to pick it up. First item out, that's just an RF extension lead. Nothing to do with Atari at all. Then for some bizarre reason, we have a Sega RF unit. That's from a Mega Drive by the looks of it, Mark 1. Does have the right connector for the Jaguar. I'm guessing they lost the original RF lead. Then we have power brick. Fortunately, this is the original one. Slightly unfortunately, it appears to have had some kind of strange repair. I don't know whether the cable broke and somebody decided to repair it themselves, or it had, well, I want to say it had the wrong end on it, but why that would be this end. So I really don't know. However, for some slightly obscure reason, there seems to be a fair amount of brand new Jaguar items around available on the internet. They're expensive. If you look on eBay, you can find brand new Atari Jaguar controllers, you can find brand new boxed games and so on. But they do hold their price. I happen to know of somewhere where I should be able to get hold of a brand new power supply. So I'm not too worried about this one. It'd be helpful if it does work though. And now the interesting parts. Let's move that away slightly. Checkered flag game. Manual. Insert. Iron Soldier game. Manual. Box for checkered flag. I don't know much about the Jaguar. Like I said, I've never played one, I don't think. Looking at the screenshots, it looks remarkably similar to Sega's Virtua Racing, which is not a bad thing. So that'll be fun to try if I can get the console working. Tempest. That is the box and inlay. And, actually, instruction manual, Tempest 2000. Instruction manual for Doom. Sadly, the cover's been torn, but the rest of it's intact, along with the box and insert. There's a cartridge for Tempest, so that's a complete box copy. Boom. Cartridge. Another complete box copy. Very interested to play that. I really hope this console works, because I'd like to try that. I'm a big Doom fan. Alien vs. Predator. One of the more popular, I believe, Jaguar games. If that's such a thing. I don't know anybody who's ever owned a Jaguar. I used to work in cash converters a long time ago, and I remember seeing one in the shop once. That was it. That's the closest I've ever had been to owning a Jaguar until today. What else have we got in here? There's the manual for Alien versus Predator. Now, you'll notice all of this is coming out of the box. So unfortunately, that means the inlay for the box is missing. But as you can see, the box is in a pretty sorry state anyway, so I'm not too worried about that. These games are worth quite a lot on their own anyway. Not that I'm buying them for resale value, I'm buying them because I want them. I want them in my collection. Double Dragon. That's an obscure title. Didn't even realise it existed on Jaguar, but then as I said, I don't know much about the Jaguar. There's a manual for Double Dragon. Cybermorph. Now, the more observant of you will notice that this is a Cybermorph bundle. So there's the cart for that. Just try and stop that falling on the floor. Alien vs Predator cart there to go with the box and manual. Double Dragon cart to go with the box and manual. Thank you. And what else is in here? Well, the important one, the main show, there is the console. Small bit of paint on the side. Other than that, that's actually in rather good nick. Don't think it's going to take much to clean it up to near mint. And then that can sit on my shelf somewhere. I really don't know much about the console. Not handled one before. But fortunately, it doesn't look like it's been opened. So that's a good sign. Power connector, TV. Horrible RF connector. I don't know why there's two connectors here. This one's labelled AV. I'm assuming that's for connecting some kind of AV module, obviously. Don't know much about it. Hopefully we can get RGB out of that. I don't know. I'll have to do a little bit of research. And then DSP. I'm assuming these arrows mean in and out. No idea. Anyway, there's the console. We've got that boy. What else is in here? The ever important ridiculous controller. I don't know who ever thought it would be good to put a telephone keypad on the middle of a controller. That is horrific. It's ridiculous. Ginormous and offers very little in the way of enhancements over a standard controller. You've got three buttons and a D-pad. No analog sticks, no extra buttons, just this ridiculous keypad. And who the hell's going to want to use that? I don't know, but it's there anyway. Again, in pretty good nick. I don't suppose this console's had a massive amount of use in its life. I mean, the box is pretty tatty, but the rest of it looks fine. That's it, actually. So let's pop that down there, right? Thought I had the manual for Cybermorph actually, unless I've buried it in this pile of boxes anyway. There we go, so that's a pretty good bundle there. I'll pop that box out of the way. I'm interested to test this out and see if it works. Crack on with business. I'm just going to pop these boxes carefully out of the way. At some point, I'm going to spend some time giving those boxes the TLC they deserve. Try and get them looking nice and neat again. Interestingly enough, you can do quite a lot with a cardboard box with an iron and a bit of patience. So I'm going to take the time to get that right. Now, before I go plugging this in, I'm going to check what's going on with this power supply, because the lady who I bought it off of told me that she hadn't a clue what it was. She didn't want to plug in this in case it killed her, so it's completely untested. I don't want to plug it in until I've checked that it's outputting the right voltage and the polarity is the right way around. What I will do though, before I start hacking anything around or do a T4, is make sure it is the right connection. Yes, that is the right fit. Odd. Really don't understand why that's on there, but we've got power connector symbol on the back matches up with what's on the power supply. So I'm going to plug this in. No explosions so far. I'm going to test it with my multimeter and check that it's actually outputting what it says it should. Last thing I want to do is go damaging my brand new purchase before I've even had a go on it. Right, centre negative it says, so if I pop that one in the centre, test the outside. Okay, just bump that up a bit. That way you can see it. It's odd. Well, the polarity's the right way around. I'm not sure why I'm getting 12 volts. Okay, well, we know the polarity's the right way around. So that's good enough for me. It's the right power supply. The polarity is the right way around and it's the right connector. There's no indication that the power supply has been tampered with apart from that lead. So I'm happy to plug this in and see what happens. RF lead. Plug that into this TFT here. Beautifully designed controller. Thank you, Atari, for this wonderful legacy. I'm not a big fan on Ataris. I remember the 2600 having quite a funky little joystick, which I thought was actually pretty good, and I was under the impression that it had a pretty good reputation as well. Used sort of rubberized membrane to make it self-centering. Try Double Dragon then. Start with, let's start with something that's quite common, Tempest. Just in case it doesn't look really obscure, I place the cartridge up. That's gone in okay. That's in. TV. Let's just set that to RF input. Okay. We'll plug the power connector in the moment of truth. Got a green light. That's a good start. I like that. No picture on the screen yet. Let's just check the RF unit's got its switch set. No, it hasn't. Right. Immediately, I've switched that over and a picture has appeared on the screen. Very fuzzy. But it says Tempest 2000. And what that tells me is that this console is working. I'm just going to go into the input list on here and see if I can tweak the tuning on here. Fine tune, is that what I want? Let's keep it there. I would imagine. Oh, that's interesting. I wonder if this RF unit's actually duff. Let me pause that a sec. Oh, I can hear some sound. I'm just going to pause the video and go and get a decent RF lead from something. Bear with me. Well, that's 20 minutes of my life that I'll never get back. Who'd have thought in 2016 an RF lead would be that hard to find? Nobody uses RF leads anymore, do they? That's why I couldn't find one. Nobody even has TVs that tune to analog input. So here we go. This is one from my Spectrum. ZX Spectrum Plus 2. Not that's particularly relevant to this video. I've just had to go out to the garage to find this. Those of you who missed it, just due to the wonders of modern technology, the camera stopped recording. The Tempest 2000 cartridge. With this new RF lead, we get a lovely clear picture. Horrible redness. Okay, I just worked out this red means it's not reading the cartridge, so bear with me a second. Now, interesting, there's no dust cover over the cartridge slot on this console, so that's obviously a bad thing. I wonder whether the cartridge slot needs cleaning as well. Could give that a go. Well, this is a beautiful clear picture, and this is brilliant. I mean, I'm so chuffed that this is working. I thought the console would be knackered, given the situation with the seller saying it was untested. But there it is. There's our nice clean picture from an RF. And it's working. I've just played a couple of minutes of this game. I'm not particularly keen on it. Seems a bit sucky to me, but yeah, there it is. Now I'm gonna switch this off and try a different cut up. Just trying to get this checkered flag game working, but it's got an American age rating on here. I'm wondering whether it's a different region and maybe there's some sort of regional lookout on it. Because I couldn't get it to do anything more than show a red screen. Let's see what we get. Yeah, like that. Yeah, that's all it looks to be doing with this cartridge. Let's try another game. Now, another thing I noticed in this pile of cartridges is that two of them, Iron Soldier here, and Checkered Flag, both appear to have had the labels punctured where the screws are. Now, I was hoping that was just somebody being a little bit overzealous with their hands, but I've just noticed that they've both got the American age ratings on them as well. I'm wondering whether there is a region lock and that might be why they're not working. Doom also has an American age rating, so let's see if that works. The label hasn't been punctured on this one. It'd be interesting. I hope this does work, because I've always wondered what the Atari version of Doom's like. No, red screen again. Press a bit in a moment. Aha, interesting. Go on. Hey. Right, 1994, yeah, so this is, I would have been 10 at the time. I'm actually a little more impressed than I was just now. I didn't realise this console was as old as that. I mean, 64-bit, yeah. I think we all know that was a lie, Atari. It's not a true 64-bit console, but this is cool. Single area 2. Huh? Co-op Deathmatch? Okay, this must be referring to the label on the front of the box saying that you can have network link up. Interesting. Area 2. Why would I want to start on Area 2? Difficulty. Obviously not going to go on that. I'm a wimp. Why are the difficulty ratings different to the PC and every other version I've played? I don't know. Let's start that. Is this going to be the... Yep, this is the level I'm used to. Okay. It's Doom. It's the cut down version of Doom. This is the same level layout as the 32X version on the Mega Drive. There's usually little islandy things there, posts, whatever you want to call them. There's also no music, which is a shame. I'm sure this console can handle music. What buttons do we have? That's shoot. That's run. That must be strafe. Yeah, okay. We've got control. Doom is a game that I'm very fond of. Spent a lot of my youth playing it on the 32X. Not the best version to play by any means, but that was what I had as a child. And I've seen it in so many iterations, I'm always curious to get hold of another copy and see what it's like. I picked up the SNES version probably about 18 months ago, after having seen that reviewed in a magazine as a child and always wondering what it played like. And I can now tell you officially, it's terrible. I was always amazed that the SNES could run Doom when the Mega Drive couldn't and you needed the 32X. I now understand why. The frame rate is appalling. It's almost unplayable. I'm not going to lie, the 32X version wasn't brilliant. It had massively cut down level layouts. A lot was lost, but it played so much better. It was smooth. It was responsive. And it was a lot more fun than the SNES version. It also had music, which this one doesn't, which is a shame. It works. I'm bloody amazed. How hard can it be to shoot a barrel? Okay, well, that's cool. I like this. Okay, let's finish this level and we'll just try another cart and see what else works. Hey, awesome. Entering plant. Cool. Right. Cool. Switch it off. Actually, just before I do that. Volume. Yeah, there's no music in this game, is there? That's a shame. Real shame. Okay, so Tempest works, Doom works. Double Dragon. Definitely going to spend some time cleaning out that cartridge slot. Double Dragon 5, that said. Oh, okay. Okay. Yep. I get it now. The box does actually say Double Dragon 5, The Shadow Falls. I'd completely missed the V and the Shadow Falls part from the title. I thought this was just Double Dragon. So this is Double Dragon 5. Tournament versus Battle Battle Demo Dossier's options. Let's go. Tournament? Oh, don't tell me this is a bloody 2D fighting game. That's the same sprite, just different colours. Okay. Yeah, location map. This is a 2D fighter, isn't it? Street Fighter style. This is a Double Dragon Eternal. Yeah, okay, well that's disappointing. I was looking forward to playing some Double Dragon. I think I understand why I've never heard of this game before. They completely spoiled the formula that was Double Dragon and turned it into a one-on-one 2D fighting game. Okay, well, it works. That's cool, but you can pause the options screen? What a bizarre console. Okay, turn that off. Alien vs. Predator. See if that works. This is looking pretty cool. Okay, I'm just going to test the rest of these games. But I'm bloody amazed. I'm really chuffed with this. I've got myself a bargain here, I think. This is a very unusual console and I'm going to spend a lot of time playing with it. But the important thing is it's working. And I'm really chuffed, so I'm just going to test the rest of the games. You don't need to watch that. and then I'll let you know what's what. Okay. Oh, there we go. Weyland Yutani. What a horrible feeling game. I suppose back in 1994, this probably would have been revolutionary. What the hell's going on? Okay, there's a marine there. Okay, yeah, that I can see that's yeah. Flamethrower, right? There's no strafe either. Okay, we've got three types of attack. Yeah, so this game was made back in 94 before first person shooters really took off, so what else did they have to compare it to? It's awful, really. This is yeah, not great by today's standards. What am I talking about? By today's standards. By anybody's standards, this is an awful first person shooter, but it's cool all the same. Right, I'll be back with you in a sec. Lots of options. Clearly nobody knew how to do menus on games back in 1994. Yeah, this is exactly the same as Virtua Racing. No idea what the controls are, man. That's that see accelerate. And that's an awful frame rate. Wow. I'm amazed that Sega let them get away with ripping off Virtua Racing. That's incredible. What's also incredible is that Virtua Racing was available on the Mega Drive, albeit with a much lower polygon count than this and much reduced graphics quality, less colours, whatever else. But it was on the Mega Drive with their special SVR chip or whatever it was. And I do recall it playing better than this. Anyway, there we go, that game works. Iron Soldier, 1994. Oh, this looks quite cool. Is this a bit like Metal Gear? Iron Metal, yeah, okay. I bet this is a Metal Gear... Metal Gear rip-off, isn't it? No, actually. Okay, what are we doing here? Select mount. Okay, exit. All systems go. You've got some polygons there. That's very not Metal Gear. Okay, this is nothing like Metal Gear at all, is it? What the hell is this? Okay. Okay, I appear to be in some sort of... what's the word I'm looking for? Mech. That's it. Oh, and there we go, we can actually move. I don't know if I'm controlling that or if it's moving itself. Okay, this is obviously the Iron Soldier. This is like a bit like Mech Warrior, I suppose. Yeah, good old Mech Warrior. Well, this is, yeah, this is pretty cool, actually. I could imagine back in 1994, people would have been drooling over this. Wow, got lots of polygons. It's moving at a reasonable frame rate. Well, yeah, this is actually pretty cool. Of the games I've tried so far, this is at the top of the list, I think. I could spend some more time playing this. Cybermorph, here we go. That's working as well. Brilliant, that's actually seven out of seven, all seven games working. I'm so chuffed with that. Absolute bargain. Well, that's fantastic. That is just brilliant. Well, there we go. My working Jaguar. Now in my collection, I'm going to clean it up, play a bit more of these games, and give it a good test. But thank you for watching. There we go. What a steal.